How are you feeling after the election?
Well, you know, it's really not over yet. So it was a lot of hard work and with a fantastic response from the people of Connecticut. But we're currently still evaluating legal options in connection with the eligibility issue concerning my opponent.
Now, when you say eligibility issue, the eligibility issue with Susan Bisowitz when she was attempting to run was one thing. It seemed to most relatively clear that George Jepson has indeed been practicing law all this time.
Well, the question isn't whether he's been practicing law. Of course, I concede that he's been a lawyer for 26 mm-hmm. years, and at some points he's practiced law. But the Supreme Court's decision in the Bisowitz case that came out just before the election made it very, very clear that practicing law is not the standard. The statute actually says 10 years of active practice at the bar. Now, the bar is a historical, traditional concept of this bar that goes across a courtroom before which, in front of which, only lawyers who are admitted to practice and argue with that to that court can proceed, can step, and the public and others have to stay behind the bar. And the Supreme Court went back and looked at the legislative history and said it was very clear that the intent was that the attorney have 10 years where he's practicing law as a primary means of making a living and actively litigating in court and actually trying cases to a judge or jury. This is very different from being a lawyer. Mm-hmm. So, mm-hmm. And you know, Ms. Bisowitz, I went to law school with her at UConn. She was there the first year. She's been a lawyer for many years, too. We both have been a lawyer for 24 years, Mr. Jepson for 26. That has nothing to do with the Supreme Court standard.
It's going to be very interesting to see how that's interpreted by the courts as it goes forward.
Well, it is, but we can see why it's so critical that an attorney general have significant and serious litigation experience. I mean, we would be immediately in court, in federal court, challenging the the requirement that individuals purchase health insurance under Obamacare. Not all of Obamacare, but that particular mandate. You know, that's a constitutional issue immediately in federal court. My opponent is not admitted to either the Second Circuit Court of Appeals or the U.S. Supreme Court. He would need to gain those admissions. He has no experience in federal court whatsoever at any time that we've been able to ascertain. He only first applied for admission to the lowest federal court just last summer, 25 years into his time of being a lawyer. This is not a good sign if you're looking for a strong attorney general who is able to both manage lawyers and stop frivolous lawsuits from going forward and identify frivolous lawsuits and train and manage the lawyers underneath her or him. And it's not a good sign if you're looking for a top advocate to go to court and really zealously advocate for Connecticut's interests.
And of course, there's very little chance that he would be protesting the health care bill in any case. He has no interest in doing that.
That's right. But let's just take an issue that Mr. Blumenthal's involved in, the No Child Left Behind mm-hmm. law. Again, a constitutional issue challenging the federal government, going up to the federal courts, and my opponent has zero experience doing that.
And you have?
I do, yes. And
now, we are here at a protest of the election in general here in the city of Bridgeport. Why are you here?
I'm here to support an effort to demand clean elections in Connecticut. It's very concerning to me that where the entire country has, you know, voiced its interest in moving in a particular direction, the entire country, Connecticut stands as a stark example of very questionable practices, not just in Bridgeport. I think New Haven is a more serious example, but in the various cities throughout the state of significant practices that undermine the right of individuals, you know, one citizen, one vote.
The suggestion here by one of the leaders is that the mayor should step down in spite of making no accusations about the mayor's role in this.
Yeah, I wasn't aware that accusation would be made, and I really have no opinion on it.
Very good. Listen, we'll find it with great interest how you go forward with this, and who is underwriting this legal challenge?
Well, so far, you know, the legal challenge was brought by my campaign.
Okay.
And well, going forward, we're working out those issues now.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Martha Dean with us here at this, this small outpouring of interest in the election here in the city of Bridgeport on the Sunday after Election Day. For doingitlocal.com, I'm David Smith.